fog pills in the windows, passes neath the lamps, settles in the doorways and huddles from the damp, slips inside the house's rooms, the sleeper's bed and dreams. It rolls him over, turns him out into the shrouded street. Dreamer, listen to the river, rubbing at the docks. Through the smoky loneliness on Siri Street we'll walk. There's someone waiting for us where the tugs are tied. His name is Louis Wagner and he's waiting there tonight. Over there by the warehouse, a shadow like a stain, a man and around his neck, look, a silver chain. He's pointing at us, fingered us. It's Wagner's laugh, all right. Shh, he's about to speak. God, look at his eyes. A night like this, just like this in March, and it was cold. John Hunford and Ivan Christensen had come in from the shoals to sell their catch and buy some bait and have themselves some rounds. Well, those crazy fools had left their wires on the Isles of Shoals alone, and they wanted me to join them, to go out baiting trawls. But in my mind flashed silver, there had been some talk about last summer out on Smutty Nose, and I was Ivan's guest. Well, I heard him whisper to his wife, let's hide the silver in the chest. So I left him in the alehouse, pulled by an undertow. I grabbed my hatchet, shoved the dory out, and I set my back to row. I rowed that dory through the night, 12 miles out to sea. 12 miles out and 12 miles back, it seemed eternity. I see the trees on Gerrish Island looming from the shore. The swell is building under me and I'm digging in the oars. And a sickle moon comes cutting across my shoulder from the east. It's colder than the hatchet blade lying at my feet. It's all darkness over Appledore, darkness over Star, darkness over Smutty Nose, pounding in the heart. And those women out there waiting, Aneth, Aneth and Marie, and Karen Ivan's sister, she was so good to me. Lungeon Island to my left, Malaga to my right, Smutty Nose lies dead ahead, I can just make out the light. And the rhythm of my rowing, it's coming faster now. The halfway rock's just off the stern, and death just off the bow. Louis, Louis Wagner, rowing through the night. Louis, Louis Wagner, the noose will fit you tight. Silver chain around your neck, silver in your eyes, silver in your Judas soul, it never, never dies. Well, the wind now whipping from the west, and the swell will not be tamed. The ocean building to a roar, and the mind will not be changed. This boat will have its landing, this sea will have its flood. These hands will have their silver, and the devil will have its blood. One lamp in the window, a beacon across the ice, safe harbor for the weary, safe keeping for the night, comfort for the sailor wrecked upon the sea, terror for those gentle folk who once befriended me. I'm gliding into Haley's Cove, and there's not a soul in sight. I grab my hatchet and I climb the bluff, headed for the light. The snow is sucking at my boots, and the ice gnawing my hands, but the blood is boiling into my veins. The blood, do you understand? I smash into the cottage, my hatchet swinging wild. Aneth leaps up from sleep, and her eyes are like a child. She screams, God, John, God, running from the room. I grab her in the doorway, the axe glints in the moon. Fire racing through my brain, explosions in my eyes. Aaron screaming, why? The axe, the blood, the sky, the moon, the pounding of the sea, the howling of the crazy wind, the wheel that wasn't me. Raging in the night, Louis, Louis Wagner, the noose will fit you tight. Silver chain around your neck, silver in your eyes, silver in your Judas soul, it never, never dies. Aneth, Aneth Christensen, her lovely golden hair, all smeared with blood, all splashed with blood. Oh, God, it was everywhere. And Karen, General Karen, she just wanted to be my friend. She made me well when I was ill. Her blood is on these hands. Marie, Marie, she got away. She ran barefoot through the snow. I followed her tracks through the craggy rocks, but the moon was falling low. And I couldn't find her anywhere, and I went back for what I came. But in the chest I only found this piece of a silver chain. Oh, this icy piece of a silver chain, and there was nothing more. I threw the chest against the wall, and I smashed the bedroom door. I ripped apart the still warm beds, I tore up every shelf. I cursed the very universe, and then I cursed myself. I stumbled down to the dory and I flung the hatchet in. I shoved off for the mainland, fighting time and wind. The dawn was breaking bloody red when I rode into Rye. I threw myself down on the beach and I hung my head and cried. And I made it to the train to Boston, but nothing was the same. And every woman on that coach kept whispering their names. Annette, Karen, they was with me all the while. And so they took me back to Kittery, where I had to stand my trial. Well, the judge was steaming on the bench, and the jury numbered 12. 1,000 eyes inside that room condemned my soul to hell. I was seated on the dock, Marie was on the stand. And right behind me, I couldn't look, were the eyes of John and Ivan. Well, the judge looked toward the doorway, and the jury disappeared. And a hush rolled through that courtroom like a fog across a pier. And the judge, he banged his gavel, and the jury took their seats. And the foreman stood, and he pointed at me, and he said, "Guilty in the first degree." Oh, the sun had not yet risen. There was a moon still in the sky. They took me from the prison with the sleep still in my eyes. And the moonlight on the gallows made that noose like a silver chain. And as I fell, I heard Karen pleading, "Louis, won't you be my friend? Oh, Louis, Louis, wag, hanging in the light. Louis, Louis, wag, now the noose now fits you tight. Silver chain around your neck, silver in your eyes, silver in your Judas soul, it never, never dies." Well, Karen's question gets no answer, for the wind's beginning to rise, and the fog's rolling out with the river. Look at the run of the tide. And now a moon, a sickle moon, it's rising just offshore. And out beyond the tugboats, listen, you can hear the dip of his oars. Dreamer in March at Portsmouth Harbor, when the night puts on her mask, and the fog prowls the dripping street, you might hear a stranger laugh. You might feel a bloody finger jabbing your marble soul. For Louis Wagner is bound to relive what happened on the Isles of Shoal.